This ICU unit in central Stockholm lies virtually empty, with just one coronavirus patient receiving care. This was the scene in April at the height of the Swedish pandemic, with the unit inundated. Outside, bars, shops and schools remained open throughout. No lockdown, but people were given official guidance on how to sanitize and when to socially distance, and they largely abided by those rules. Masks were never mandated here, with a senior government source telling CNN that they're regarded here as largely superficial. After an initial surge in the death rate, well above the Scandinavian average, Sweden now has one of the lowest death rates in Europe. Most of the casualties were elderly. 9 out of 10 were over 70 years old, and 45% of all deaths were in care homes. That's raised the question about the rest of society, the younger, the healthier. Did they develop some sort of resistance to the virus as they interacted?
It's possible that we have been building up some immunity that contributes to the present state.
But when people in Stockholm were tested for immunity, only 7% had enough antibodies to fight the disease. But they weren't tested for T cells, which also provide resistance.
So that means that immunity in Sweden and immunity globally is probably larger than we have previously appreciated. At least that is our current thought.
And that's the narrative that some American conservatives are grasping onto. Why bother with lockdowns and masks when you can allow people to go about their normal lives, catch the virus and build immunity, whilst only shielding the elderly and vulnerable? The Swedish government urges caution, pointing to how their safety guidelines were followed by most Swedes, but also a universal healthcare and welfare system that provides a safety net for anyone falling ill or out of work.
Minister.
Lena Hallengren oversaw the government response from the beginning as health minister.
We didn't have a full or a forced lockdown, but we had many changes, a large number of changes in the Swedish society. I mean, during the spring, we had distance studies for, or online studies for all upper secondary, for the universities and the adult schools. We also had, I think, 30-40% people working from home. We have lots of people staying home on sick leave because they have the slightest symptoms. You could go out the streets in the capital. You didn't meet almost anyone. We have lots of businesses with a very difficult situation because they didn't have any guests or customers. So lots of things were changed. You didn't have any cultural event, the sports event. So things were changed, but not in a forced way. I think that was the difference.
The Swedish economy shrank by 8% in the second quarter of 2020, the largest fall since records began. But what of the bigger price? The many elderly who died, some argue were sacrificed in the early days of the pandemic.
If you get the virus into those elder care homes, many of the persons living there are having very severe symptoms and also die. So that's why we have this, by law, that people were forbidden to visit the elder care homes, but that was not successful in all the way. But we also learned a lot of that.
All care home workers have since been retrained in hygiene protocols. The government here says it's too early to know what they did right, what they did wrong, or whether herd immunity for coronavirus is even a thing. In the meantime, they're preparing for a possible second wave this fall. It wouldn't be the first country to see a surge in the virus after apparently stamping it out.